Good morning. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm gonna do a bit of like a career update and, you know, whatever. So, mental health update as well. Prozac update, whatever, in that area of those two things. I hope you enjoy the video and keep on watching. So, if I seem groggy, I am. I just woke up, like I did my little hygiene, and then I was like, you know, I feel like talking. So, I'm still waking up. But, recreational therapy update. I did get a job, guys. People who have came here through that topic. I did get a job, but I chose to decline the offer. We'll get into that. But I also got a caregiving job, which I've had before. I happened to get both of these jobs at the same time, but I was not applying to the caregiving job. I was just going in there to say hello, because after I had left, it was a great company. I just went on to do other things. And I always said I would go back and say hello, and I honestly had not. I think I did I just would see them out and about, like in the city, and say hello when I saw them. So I was like, you know, I've been riding my bike, because I was doing the 75 hard challenge, by the way, and I have to start that over because I did not do everything I was supposed to do one day. Anyway, different something else. I was riding my bike around because I was doing my outdoor workout as part of that little challenge. And I was like, you know, let me stop by, because they're right across the street from me. And I went in there, masked on, you know, and I was just saying, hey. They were like, oh, you're here to apply? And I was like, that I am not. And I truly wasn't, like, I wasn't. Because my goal was to, at that time I had two full-time job interviews. So I was really trying to find full-time work benefits and in my field that I like went to school for. So I was like, y'all, both of those jobs were in Virginia Beach, which is, depending on what part of Virginia Beach, can be 40 plus minutes away. I was not trying to work there, no. But somehow, between me having a hard time telling people no, which I'm working on, I mean, I'm pretty good at that, but it didn't work. So I got the job there. I was like, I don't want to be flaky. I was being very honest, to the point where, like, you think they'd be like, you know what, never mind, because you seem really uncertain, which I was. But I was like, I have bigger commitments. Like, I'm not putting you first, is what I'm saying. Like, I'm not gonna make it a priority, essentially. And they were like, well, we appreciate the honesty, but if you, you know, want to join or apply, you know, you got it. And I was like, and it was just a group of these lovely older ladies, like the sweetest old ladies. They're not old, but they're older than me. And just smiling at me, and I was like, you know, I literally said, you know, sure. And they literally like, oh my God, virtual hug. Like, it was, so yeah. But that was how I got that job. The reason why I explained all of that was because when I didn't get one of the Virginia Beach jobs, but I got another one. And the reason why the caregiving one ties in is because the reason why I had to decline the job offer was because they offered me the job on that Friday. Then the days in the week go by, like Monday went by, I checked email all day, nothing. Tuesday, sent an email, got nothing. I called the place more than seven times, at least seven times. And what would be so crazy is some of the times when I would call, the person at the front desk would be like, wow, they still haven't sent you your information yet, like. And the person was like, that's ridiculous. And on top of that, a person who I found out about the job through, or by, whatever's proper, let me know that it wasn't the best work environment for her. So, and I feel kind of like I'm risking it saying all this up here on the off chance that these employers see it, but I mean, that was an issue. And it wasn't just an issue that I, saw. I was expressing in detail what was occurring to me, to friends, to my supervisor at my current job, because we're friends as well. Hi, Kenesha, we're friends. Because you be playing. everyone was in agreement that they were not communicating well. Like, I never did get the offer letter. And when I did finally get a response from somebody via email, I never could get through on the phone. I left voicemail after voicemail. I ended up calling one day and getting, I feel like I just skipped around, but you know, sorry. I got somebody who was like, you know what, this is ridiculous. Because I kept asking to speak to a certain individual who was the director of the facility. And finally got through to her. Then I was texting her. And even the communication there was not the best. I was asked a question, I would respond to said question and get nothing back. And that person said they were doing something personal. So I tried to respect the ideal amount of time that certain situation probably took. But at the end of the day, you're the director of an establishment. Hello. So I, several hours later, messaged and said, hope all is well, and proceeded to answer the question and say, you know, I can do this. My supervisor was nice enough to work with me while I was making this transition because she supported me finally going into my field that I like went to school for. And I just would never get a response. And then I called, was sent to voicemail, or it rang a few times and then it ended. And then I got a text message that said, can you call back later? I'm putting all the business out there, but anyway. A lot of runaround, and it seemed like they weren't trying to be forthcoming with pertinent information, because when I sent the email that I was going to be declining the job offer, because, I mean, I didn't say why, I just said that. All the emails I had sent, this was the first email they responded to quickly, or no, they didn't respond by email, but they responded quickly by calling me, the director did, because she had sent me, I had asked her when she wanted me to come in for training, because that's the question she asked me, and she never responded. So after that, I was talking with my supervisor, actually, and was like, bro, I'm over it. And she was like, honestly, cut the cord, as well as my parents, said that a little bit more protective and parental. But everybody essentially was saying the same thing, like it was ridiculous, like the person even at that place said. So, and I happened to get another job, so when they called me, I let them know that I got a different job. And also I want to, because I applied for my master's in public health, and as I was completing my bachelor's degree, working where I work now at Parks and Recreation, it is the best job to have, like, as a student. Because it's not that hectic, it's not a chaotic job, so it's easy if you utilize your time, you know, you still have to choose to study. But that environment was, I easily could study, I could get things done regarding like school, so. And I also worked as a caregiver while I was in college, and you assist the people and things, but you're taking care of seniors, so most of them are chilling. You're there to assist with the things so they don't have to get up. So I could study there too while getting my work done. Yeah, so I told them the truth, like that I was gonna focus on school and that I got another job, but I also was like, you know, communication just wasn't kind of there. To which they always had a response saying that they happened to have state inspections going on. And they were like, well, we did let you know that we were busy and we just had a lot going on. And in one email, they even mentioned, like, anyway. And I did my best to keep that in consideration. But I just feel like you're a healthcare business and a business nonetheless. You're gonna have multiple things going on. So one, I don't understand why you were in the hiring process. Well, I do, you're trying to fill a position so that it would be less chaotic. However, it shouldn't have been difficult to send an offer letter, which there's something else to that. And to get back to me with questions you would ask. So they just were not, to me, I'm like, if I'm having a headache at this point and I haven't even met you individuals or stepped foot at the facility, and the person who was there before really told me she went, it affected her emotionally and mentally working there. I didn't need any more signs. I feel like God was just like, hello. Like, I feel like I was being bombarded with the most apparent red flags, if there were any to be seen. So let that go. And I felt like I was like, my supervisor and I joked, but it was like I was in like a short toxic relationship, just for the fact, just the back and forth. And I kept feeling like I was getting my hopes were high. Like, if you see my videos, like, you know, I've been wanting to work, like I want a full-time job. So I was super excited when I got that one, especially because I didn't get the other one. But just all that run around, and then on the phone call, speaking of the offer letter, like before, when I emailed that I was declining, the director called me with the girl who I emailed, who never responded that much, said, what did she say? The reason why she hadn't sent the offer letter was because they need to know like when you're gonna start or something before they send out some type of information. In my head, I'm like, one, why didn't you just say that instead of ignoring me? And two, that doesn't make sense because I've gotten jobs before this where I didn't know when I was about to start and they sent me the offer letter. The offer letter just entails the job, benefits if any, the tasks and duties. You can do that. So after explaining all of that to the people close to me and just following my own gut feeling, I just let that go. And so, and really the pay wasn't reflective of one, my education and my certification. So yeah, so that's the update on jobs. I am pretty bummed about it. I like to think that I'm not, but I guess I am. I'm only bummed for the fact that I was just excited to do what I love to do, and which is taking care of people. I love to take care of people, but I loved caring for seniors. Like, that is my calling, and I specifically love it for the rewarding feeling it gives me helping anybody's loved one. But when I care for my own, like I care for my grandma, my great grandma, but definitely because my grandma was here to also take care of her mother, which is my great grandma. So my grandma did most of that, but that was my first I feel like I said that weird, but that was my first introduction into caring for an elder. And so getting much older, having been a caregiver, and then my grandma having to utilize those same services, that's what I want to do. So I was super excited and pretty bummed when it just was kind of falling apart. So, and another reason is because I'll be 26 next year.
Yay.
And like super pumped, feeling blessed to continue to age. It's a fantastic thing. But I will no longer be, my parents had such great insurance that I was able to be on it till 26. That'll be next year. It's crazy how, wow, we age fast, okay? I really wanted to be able to support myself by now. Not even by 26. At 24, I was on the cusp when I got my first Virginia Beach job, and funds for it got dissolved because of COVID, which I was also, oh my gosh, why can I not talk? I was also watching this YouTube channel called Soft White Underbelly. Put a screenshot here. Probably for my mental health, it's not the best that I binge watch those videos, but a lot of people, those people go through some things, and I also forgot what I was correlating that to. I think I was just mentioning that, but I don't know. That sucks. I wish I could rewind it, but I definitely can't. But I could pause it and see what I was saying. I try not to be hard on myself about what I can't control, especially since that is the advice I'm forever giving to people. But reflecting like to myself, I know there's a lot of reasons why I'm so eager to be there. One, I just want to be able to support those that I care about. Like, I want to work caring for people, and I want to be able to support people. I want to be able to support myself. I want to be able to travel. Like, I have self-care and, you know, whatever. I do put myself first. I try to. I'm doing better at that. But I want to be able to care for my parents the way my parents worked to be able to do that for their parents. I want to be able to, when I am blessed to have children, when I'm ready to, I want to be able to put them in any type of activity that they may have an interest in. I want to be able to take them to do fun things, like on the whim. So, yeah, I just want to be able to live a happy life I'm satisfied with. So, and I see, like in those videos and with people I know, how crazy life can get and where it can take you. So I just want to live the best happy Christ-like life that I can. I try to be as Christ-like as I can. We all obviously get into things, but and that's speaking of Christ, the Lord Savior Jesus Christ, I really have felt his presence outside. even in getting this job, because I don't want to say all that. It's like, this is tough because I want to be as honest as I can, but I'm also trying to be smart. But yeah, I just want to be great. But don't we all just want to be great? Anyway, that's the job update. Hope that was straight arrow. I hope it made sense from start to finish, because I can be all over the place when I am getting feelings out. And I also kind of want to vent right now, but what I want to vent about is not for YouTube. So there's that. And that sounds really dark out loud, but it's nothing. Okay, I'll just edit that out. I guess I can say, on the mental health front, anybody is aware that I take Prozac 20 milligrams. Been taking that for, to be honest. Okay, I had a 6-month update when, where's my phone? Because I was listening to music. Wow, it's been there the whole time. So I was 6 months on it 2 months ago. So 8 months now. Wow, that's about right. Wow, I've been taking the Prozac for 8 months. Actually, I'm just gonna do a Prozac video. So thank you for watching. My battery's dying. I wish everybody good health and prosperity. That's all. Okay.